Kavita Krishnan and Satinath Sarangi, I want to give you a live display that when you both speak over each other, you end up neutralizing each other's voice. That's all that you've done
That's
for the last 4 minutes.
You speak over everyone all the time so much so that even you
and Samit Patra do the same thing with each other.
There's no need to get personal with me, Satinath.
Exactly.
You know when you make those kind of comments for me, it's like water off a duck's back, man. You know that.
We all know that, Arnab.
Thank you, Kavita. I'm just asking you, Arnab.
Yeah, but answer the question.
Thank you, Kavita. My question tonight is this. And my question is to Satinath Sarangi. Please, Jatinath Sarangi, take my question now. My question is that as per the MHA affidavit, they say it's the result of such representations that adverse observations have been made against India by the European Union with regard to Dalit rights. Now, my question is, why should we be inviting, as proud Indians, a sanctions regime against our own country? And the fact is this, Kavita, relax.
One second.
For a country.
I don't get it.
For a country. You need to get it. You need to listen, Kavita. You know, for a country that has a Supreme Court, we have a country. We have a country. I'm proud of my country's Supreme Court. Now, Kavita, the problem with you is anyone disagrees with you, you speak over the other person. So just relax, Kavita. Relax, Kavita. You know, please listen. I'm not among those journalists who get impressed with just the NGO talk. Now, my question is very simple.
I am proud of my country's Supreme Court.
I have a Supreme Court that has cancelled fraudulently. Now, I have a Supreme Court. Miss Kavita Krishnan, please. Now, Miss Kavita Krishnan, take the question that is given to you. Miss Kavita Krishnan, take the question given to you. And I know the problem with all the NGO types. The moment you ask them a question, the moment you don't take the NGOs at face value, they just keep talking.
Well, you haven't still answered my question.
So here's the question.
Please remember that.
Mr. Sarangi, the problem with you and Kavita Krishnan is you are displaying such a level of intolerance on the program tonight towards any opinion different from your own. I worry for both of you.
Not at all. You answer a simple question.
I worry for the intolerance that is creeping in your mind.
That Indian poor people should be deprived of
Miss Kavita Krishnan. Miss Kavita Krishnan and one second, Miss Krishnan. Miss Krishnan. Miss Krishnan, my question to you is, who on earth are the British? What did the British ever do? Miss Kavita Krishnan, you tell me. From historical precedent, what did the British ever do? What did the British ever do for the poor people of India that you go crying to them now? What did the British ever do for the poor people of India that you go crying to them now? And you have no faith in our institutions. You go crying before their parliament. You think the British are going to give you justice?
You are defending your government.
Miss Kavita Krishnan, have some self-respect. You are an Indian, for God's sake. Have some self-respect, Kavita Krishnan.
You should have some self-respect. You are speaking for the British.
I don't understand why
the British
killing
Adivasis, taking away their
livelihood. I don't understand this. In today's day and age, we have a group of Indians who believe the British will deliver justice. I open this up for debate. Anyone else wants to come in? I open this up for debate. One second. I just cannot understand. Sambit Patra. Sambit Patra, please, on this subject. Sambit Patra.
Yes, Arnab, I want to make a very important point. Arnab, it is appalling to know that we have friends in this panel who believe that Britishers can salvage the poor of this country, and they do not feel that the Supreme Court of this country, that the democratic structure of this country can do anything for the poor of this country. I'm appalled. I'm really appalled. Ms. Kavita Krishnan, you should retract such statements.
BJP government needs to salvage the poor of this country. We believe that the government of India needs to ensure that the Foreign Rights Act is implemented.
Mr. Sambit Patra, has your party taken funding from Vedanta or not? Did not the Delhi High Court say that a British company, Vedanta, had illegally funded your party, the Bharatiya Janata Party, and the government in violation of FCRA regulations?
Our party is our party business. But tell me, do you have to rush to? Do you have to rush to the British Parliament crying about India? From whom we take our fundings is a matter which is open to the Election Commission. Go and petition the Election Commission.
I've opened up the lines now.
Look after it.
I want it.
lecture you have been doing is an open question today.
You have been selling this country.
People like you have been selling this
country. People like you have been, in fact, selling this country. And that is what my question is. Why do you sell this country? Under whose pretext you are selling this country? Miss Kavita Krishnan, answer. Who makes you sell this country? Why have you no self-esteem as an Indian? Why have you more faith in the European Parliament? Why do you have to rush to the British Parliament if you want protection in India? Don't you have faith in the democratic institutions of this country? It's a matter of shame. Have some shame, Miss Kavita Krishnan.
Have some shame.
Are there any links?
Have some shame, Ms. Kavita Krishnan, that you have no faith in India.
In
that you believe that
FCRA
if anyone can salvage this country, it is a Britisher.
My question is tonight, you take one
Ms. Kavita Krishnan,
down,
our
second,
funding is
one
looked after by the Election Commission, by the income tax law of this land. Our funding is looked after by the Election Commission and the income tax law of this land.
Ms. Kavita Krishnan,
why do you, Ms.
Krishnan, one second, John Dayal, I see your hand out there. Kavita Krishnan says tonight, I'm fighting for Adivasis. I want to teach Kavita Krishnan a little bit about Indian history. Kavita Krishnan, it will do
you
some good. Kavita Krishnan, I think you should understand a little bit of your own country's history. Kavita Krishnan, the Adivasis of India fought and listen completely to one sentence. Kavita Krishnan, listen to this sentence, please, and don't speak over me. Listen to this, Miss Kavita Krishnan. Listen to this, Miss Krishnan.
Today in fighting the British,
I'll tell you one thing. You see, Kavita Krishnan says tonight.
Like today,
relax, Miss Krishnan.
And it is you and
Kavita Krishnan
that is peddling, that is being.
You know, Kavita Krishnan, you don't know anything about Indian history. It is clear to me you have absolutely no knowledge of Indian history. If you did, then you would realize that the Adivasis of India fought British exploitation of their land and resources. The Adivasis of India fought British. Allow me to complete. The Adivasis fought the British, and the Adivasis were looted. The British Empire was built on looting Adivasis, Miss Kavita Krishnan. It is one of the greatest travesties of our time that today it is one of Miss Kavita Krishnan. 1 minute, please stop. Kavita Krishnan, don't go on and on and on and on and on like a broken record. Remember the Birsa Mundas, please.
I'm asking you.
Remember the Birsa Mundas. I am asking you, is it true or not? Is it true or not, Miss Kavita Krishnan? Do you not have the patience or the decency to listen?
Do you have the decency?
Do you have the decency to listen?
What is the difference between the British Indians?
Miss Kavita Krishnan, I am asking you from Indian history.
Colonial Raj and between Vedanta today.
I am telling you.
If you have any decency at all, tell me why the Adivasis.
I will, but he's on another subject. 1 second, please, Kavita Krishnan. Kavita Krishnan.
Why should a self-respecting
Miss Kavita Krishnan, you know the problem is when someone.
You are looting their land. It is our government, the Company Raj government.
Okay, let's put her on air, let her go on.
These foreign corporations to come in and loot the land of our Adivasis. You tell me, Arnab, you who know history so well, why the Adivasi inspired by Birsa Munda should not fight back
Kavita,
against Vedanta and SR, should
Kavita
not fight
Krishna.
Back against any government, be it a Congress
Kavita,
or BJP government, that
subject,
is taking funding from those very corporations
not on this
and
subject.
Then cracking down, killing the Adivasis who are
protesting.
You tell me why any self-respecting Indian should not stand by that struggle.
No.
That is the question.
1 second.
My question to Kavita Krishnan is again.
Sambit, 1 second.
You have the right to fight back. Why not through the Supreme Court of India? Why not through the judicial system of India? Why not to the Parliament of this country? Why in the Parliament of UK and European Union? This is the question.
What we have done.
Why in the UK Parliament?
Exactly what we have done.
Don't you have faith in the Indian Parliament?
Just one word, Sambit.
Don't you believe that the parties of India are efficient enough to stand with the tribals?
Can we have one person on the screen at a time?
We are here because
Kavita,
you
not for the tribals that you are fighting, but for your petty selfishness that you are fighting.
That is the slogan I answer to today.
Not for the tribals.
Kavita Krishnan, 1 minute. There has to be a limit, please. Miss Kavita Krishnan, I'm sorry, but there has to be a limit to bad behavior on television. Please stop. I'm requesting you have some decency on the program. I will not allow you to get away with this. I've allowed you to go on and on for a long enough time. Have some decency now. There are other panelists on the debate. Don't think that you have the moral right to speak over everyone.
I have the moral.
No, you wouldn't. You wouldn't allow someone else to do it. So don't do it over others. Enough, Ms. Kavita Krishnan. Enough. I have listened to you enough. Don't go non-stop on the program.
You have no business.
You better keep quiet now, Ms. Krishnan. There are others on the channel.
Please do. Please let John speak. You haven't let him speak
Ms. Krishnan,
a word yet.
First of all, you calm down and keep quiet.
He's the
now,
one panelist who has
we have several callers calling in. We have one caller. Sanju is a... One second, please. One minute, Kavita. Relax, please, Kavita Krishnan. Okay?
You relax.
Take a deep breath.
You do. You need it.
Your bad behavior is evident to everyone tonight,
Ms. Krishnan. Can I kindly come in?
Sanju is calling in from Thiruvananthapuram, and my question continues to be, and John Dayal, actually let me get in John Dayal at this point. John Dayal, why do Indians go begging before foreign bodies? Why do they? You made a appearance before the US committee. One second, just a minute, let me complete. My information Indians is that you like made an appearance before the U.S. Committee on Religious Freedom in 2014.
Yes.
Now, if the Indian Parliament Committee would call American activists to plead before it or describe the levels of racism in America, which I was just discussing on debate number one, how would the Americans react?
I would say, let the Americans squirm.
No. Don't get
if
away with that. That's not a good
country,
answer.
It should be out in the open.
No. Why don't you go to Mr. John Dayal, that's an ineffective reply. Mr. John Dayal, allow me. You went before the American Committee on Religious Freedom in 2014 and spoke about how there was lack of religious freedom in India, which again is huge overstatement. Why don't you today go to Seattle, United States and do a dharna outside the temple, right? Where there was a racist emblem put out there. Why don't you go to Alabama, to Madison, to go and fight for Suresh Patel?
Arnab, I will go there tomorrow if you give me a ticket. I would love to.
So you need the funding, that's all. Anyone who pays for a ticket for you, that's all they need to do. Anyone just pays a ticket, you
go and do it. I just need a ticket to go there because I have no money.
No,
I am not an FCRA group.
What is this?
Not to me. Give me the money.
Mr. John Dayal, you get 600 crores every year from the U.S.
Give me the money.
Towards payment of fees and printing of
give me the money.
No, anyone
who has the MHF figures I'm giving you.
Give me the money. Yeah. Give me the money.
This is decent.
Please sign the money.
This is decent or not?
1 second.
Give me the money.
I don't understand. Is it about belief or money? Or is it about selling your national interest? I don't get it, John Dayal. What is your argument?
Who is this man and where does he get my bank account number? I have not got the 15 lakhs which Mr. Modi has promised from black money.
No, Mr. John Dayal, please tell me. 1 second, relax, please. Arisen Singh, please calm down. Mr. John Dayal, please tell me, what have you done about the growing incidence of racism and religious intolerance in the United States of America? Because you go crying to the Americans, right? My information is that you went crying to the Americans in 2014. Allow me to complete. Now, my information also is that under the Barack Obama government...
I went angry.
1 second, Mr. John Dayal. Mr. John Dayal, under the Barack Obama government, under the Barack Obama government, in the United States of America, the incidence of religious intolerance, racism and violence against Indians and people from different religious groups, including Hindus and Muslims, have been growing. I want to know what you've done about that. And when you went to America, did you tell the Americans to first clean their own backyard? Why didn't you?
Always.
Did you
always.
Tell them, what did you told them to clean,
clean
their own backyard?
Clean your own backyard.
You told
but
them
the
to
world
clean their own backyard?
Is one village.
No, 1 second.
Of course, always.
Don't lecture me.
Always. Always. And that is what I tell the government of India. Clean your own backyard. Don't sell out to foreign and Indian companies.
No, I don't understand. You didn't answer my question. When did you ever go and tell the Americans about the religious intolerance in their country
I have.
Before begging before begging for their ear in Washington?
Always. I write about it every day.
Then why were you going there begging before the U.S. Congress?
I don't beg.
No, then what were you doing? Why would any self-respecting Indian go and depose against his country? Did you depose against India? Did you depose against India, Mr. John Dayal, before the U.S. Committee on Religious Freedom in 2014?
Never.
Did you make a deposition before a formal committee of a foreign parliament?
Never.
Did you go before the U.S. Committee on Religious Freedom in 2014?
Yes.
Did you or did you not?
Yes.
Then admit it.
Yes.
Then admit it. Why were you saying no till
now? No, but I did not depose against India. I deposed against religious hatred by political groups. And I'll do it again.
There you are. And what about religious hatred and racial violence in America?
Which is a patriotic act.
No, what about religious hatred?
I will do it at the United Nations.
What about?
And I will do it in the Supreme Court of India, as I've done repeatedly.
Okay, so that's it. You will do it again.
Exactly.
Now, G.D. Bakshi wants to come back to the debate, so does Sambit Patra. We have people here today who say, we have people here today, and by the way, no, 1 second. You should first understand the way the, you know, other countries react. The same countries which roll the red carpet to you will cry sedition if a person with separatist views is allowed to depose before a foreign parliament.
Are you suggesting that we've never protested against America, Arnab? Surely that you've often attacked me for doing precisely that, actually.
Ms. Krishnan, you are not even getting the point tonight. G.D. Bakshi is coming to the debate. Few more minutes on the debate.
Okay.
Against racism in America, against...
G.D. Bakshi, please. G.D. Bakshi, please. Yes, G.D. Bakshi.
In which John has attended all those protests.
G.D. Bakshi, please.
Arnab,
G.D. Bakshi, please.
Arnab, can I kindly speak? Arnab, as a soldier, I am deeply, deeply pained that the British who caused the famine of Bengal, the great famine of Bengal that killed millions, the British who carried out the Jallianwala Bagh massacre, it is to that forum these people, these so-called Indians, have gone to plead. Just like before independence, Indians used to go to the Privy Council seeking colonial justice. You know, there are some people who still think they are in a time warp.
Filthy.
You know, they are in a time warp. And it is all a part of that racist agenda. The brown and the black people cannot govern themselves. And our brown representatives must go and plead before the British Parliament. They must go before the United States Congress. Let them first set their house in order. And let these Indians have some iota of self-respect.
It's quite clear here. You know, there are different points of view. Now, my question, I'll take a break because I have to, and I'll come back and open up to calls. One minute.
Do exactly what they did.
My limited point is today there are Indian citizens who expect the British to deliver Adivasis in India. They must really get their history lessons right. This is the biggest joke I've heard in a long time. And yes, Sambit Patra wants to respond. Sambit Patra. And by the way, John Dayal.
John Dayal, one second.
I have just been informed that you've used objectionable language vis-a-vis General Bakshi. Did you use objectionable language vis-a-vis General Bakshi right now?
I have not spoken.
Are you asking?
No.
Objectionable.
Where? What?
Did you use the word filthy?
What did I say? No. Who is this man? What is he saying?
Okay. Because, you know, don't get personal with the panelists. Sambit Patra wants to respond. Sambit Patra. Even if you're on the losing side of the debate, don't get personal. Yeah.
Let me congratulate you.
One second, please. Sambit Patra is coming back to the debate.
That is like the British East India Company.
It's like saying we'll go to the East India Company to revive the Indian economy.
Congratulate Arnab Goswami. You have exposed them as never before. I've been debating with you since long, but I'll tell you, this debate of yours is one of the best debates that I have been, because today, many people who have been taking anti-India stand have been exposed over here. And to add to what you said on report on religious freedom, the report on religious freedom came on February 2014. And I'm sorry to say, Arnab, I'm sorry to say, let Kavita Karan and hear what the report was. Let Father John Dan hear what the report was. The report placed India as the lowest category alongside Pakistan as the country of particular concern, CPC or not. Let Kavita Krishnan see this. Kavita, listen to this. Kavita, because of your activities, the report on religious freedom that was placed by the US in February 2014 places India as the lowest category alongside Pakistan. Are we as bad as Pakistan? Father John Dayal? Are we as bad as Pakistan, Kavita Krishnan? Answer me today. Answer India today. You have to answer India today. You have hurt India. Both of you have hurt India. Answer India.
Thanks to the Sangha Parivar.
One second. Our first caller is Subhash from Nashik.
Listen to India, Kavita.
Our first caller is Subhash from Nashik. Subhash, one second, please. Let's hear the callers now. Kavita, Subhash is calling in from Nashik.
You have made India.
Subhash is calling in from Nashik. Please, Kavita, I request you. Please, Kavita, I request you. Subhash is calling in from Nashik, please. Yes, Subhash.
Good evening, Arnab.
Yes.
Arnab, I know I have a question for Ms. Gopal. Okay, the question is in two parts. You know, Mr. Singh levied some serious charges about, you know, Greenpeace being involved into this foreign funding racket, some things which she deflected that question. She didn't answer to that question if they have suffered those losses in that money transfer and all those things. She deflected that question. This is the one part of the question. And my second question to Ms. Gopal again is that she was about to reveal something about, you know, getting those cyber hack people, like, you know, she said that there are companies which hold a lot of data. Okay, so is Greenpeace involved? Ask her this question, but she deflected that and she didn't answer. So I want to know her, that is Greenpeace into hacking accounts, Indian accounts, corporate accounts?
Yeah, so there are two questions, both which went unanswered. The first question is there any, is Greenpeace involved in any forex dealing?
Greenpeace is a global organization. It has funds from many countries. It needs to manage those funds. And therefore, we have to ensure that foreign currencies that are held with Greenpeace International are protected. Greenpeace International has to protect the funds of its supporters, which come in from different countries. We work in 42 countries. And therefore, Greenpeace International has to manage funds that come in from different countries.
You're 100% Indian funded.
I spoke about Greenpeace International. Greenpeace India is funded by Indians. 74% of our funds come from Indians. Of course, we do also get foreign funding, which recently the Delhi High Court told the MHA that they were acting arbitrarily and illegally to block those funds. So the Delhi High Court, which we very much respect, and we respect other courts in India, has actually told the MHA that they have acted illegally to block our funds.
The
institutions we respect are actually... The other question on cyber activism, I think I would like to answer it so that it isn't said that I'm deflecting. Greenpeace India has a database of... More than 50,000 people who have given us funds. We need to protect that database. Exactly. And therefore, we need to ensure the security of that database. And therefore,
In all of India, there are no people in a country which is the knowledge superpower of the world. In all of India, you couldn't find two people who could manage data.
All of whom are going to
USA. Well, we happen to have those experts in other parts of the country. We use that expertise. We are a global entity. We use
are they cyber hacking experts
globally, and I'm sure any organization that has expertise in the organization would actually use it.
Are they cyber hacking experts
to hire people from outside?
Do these people have cyber hacking skills? Do these people, Ms. Gopal, do these people have cyber hacking skills?
As well as we possibly can, and therefore we use expertise that exists within the organization, and we don't spend that money in hiring new talent when we already have that talent in the organization.
Okay, Haldane is calling in from Kochi. She's a teacher. Yeah, go ahead.
Okay, Arnab, nice to be in your show.
Yeah.
Okay, my question is simple. Hello, my question is simple.
Yeah, go ahead.
Okay, the question is, why government is not working on the behalf of the tribals, and why these people like the Greenpeace and etc. is coming in favor of these people? Actually, the problem is government is not working in favor of the Adivasis and the most of them, in particular in Kerala, in Attapadi and all. The government is extremely worse in taking care of these Adivasis. That is the real problem, Arnab. Yes, just ask them, the government people, whatever the government people, ask them.
But Mr. Haldane,
I must congratulate Ms. Kavita, okay, Kavita, for her work, for her social work, okay.
Okay, so your point is very well taken. Only thing I don't understand how we can expect a bunch of British MPs to help us. It just doesn't make
British
sense.
MPs
unless we want to get lectured by the British.
The company in question is a British Ravi Kumar, company, which I think you...
Ravi Kumar is calling from Chennai. Ravi Kumar is the next caller from Chennai. Let's take a quick round.
The company in question, which is violating Indian laws in Mahan, is a British registered company called SR.
There is something called an Indian court.
So please let the government answer why they're protecting
Ravi Kumar is calling in from Chennai.
Is SR interest equal to Indian interest?
Are
the interests of the tribal people something that the government of India should protect?
Ravi Kumar, please understand one thing. Pillai's testimony is not free speech. It was paid for and organized by a British NGO, and so it is motivated testimony to serve a foreign country's foreign policy interest. Just look at the whole thing logically. You see, don't look at it only from your organizational perspective, look at it from a national perspective for once, please. And I insist, if you think the British are going to deliver Indian Adivasis, you must live in another planet, really. We all know, can't become Macaulay's children overnight. Ravi Kumar from Chennai is calling. Ravi Kumar. Last caller is Ravi Kumar from Chennai.
Indian laws.
Hi, Arnab.
Okay, Ravi Kumar from Chennai has a question. Yeah.
Good evening, Arnab.
About British companies.
Ms. Gopal, the question is to you, perhaps.
Companies' interests with national interests.
Okay, heard you. Now, please hear this side.
Yeah. Mr. Greenpeace. Why should they invite the cyber expert from the foreign soil?
Exactly. Why?
Sir, because we really respect the money that we get from more than 50,000 Indians, which we have to use efficiently. So when the organization actually has that skill within the organization, we don't want to waste money paying it for hiring a new person to do the job. When we have that skill set, why can't we use it? We have a database of Indian supporters who give us secure information like their credit card numbers, like their bank account details. We cannot allow that information to be hacked.
Therefore,
we have to ensure the highest security protocols. And we do it in the most efficient manner possible.
Well, you know, these are all written statements that you're reading out. We do it in the efficient manner possible, etc. The question
companies
is,
like
the
Vedanta, question is, companies like Dow, companies like SR.
I think you don't.
For me, the most important issue is that you repose greater faith in British forums than Indian institutions. This is totally unacceptable.
Fight for his country?
Totally unacceptable. And I find it thoroughly shocking. I find it thoroughly shocking that in the India of 2014, you can have Indians who believe that British MPs will care and Britain will deliver Indian Adivasis. I think Kavita Krishnan, go back and see. Go back and see. Read. Remember one thing.
I hope the government of India is
remember one protect. Thing. Remember one thing, Kavita Krishnan. Miss Kavita Krishnan, I'm not saying something to you. Listen, there are no free lunches. If anybody is paying anybody, sending their agents, sending their experts, they're expecting something in return. My question is, what is that which they're expecting in return? If you expect me to believe, if you expect me to believe that a bunch of British organizations and British lobbyists and British MPs will deliver justice for Indian Adivasis, I refuse to believe it. Your faith is greater than mine. I'll take this debate forward.
I agree with you. There are no free lunches.
I will take this debate forward.
Why it's protecting
but I'm short of time tonight, only for tonight, with a promise to come back on this debate. Thank you for joining me on debate number 2 on the News Hour tonight.